Meldy's experiment. In this Meldy's experiment, we have to determine the frequency of electrically maintained tuning fork and to verify the lambda square T law. So, this is your experimental arrangement of your Meldy's experiment. This is your tuning fork. In between the tuning fork, you have placed the electromagnet and a battery is connected to the electromagnet. So, when the screw touches the plate connected to the tuning fork, it produces vibration in the thread or the string, and the thread is hanged with the weight support through a pulley. We go on adding the mass in the pan, so the number of loops gets changed. So this is the transverse arrangement. In what happens in transverse arrangement, that the particles are vibrating in a direction perpendicular to the direction of the wave. So this is the longitudinal arrangement. In this, the tuning fork has been placed perpendicular as was in the arrangement of transverse wave. So again, when you switch on the circuit, the vibrations are produced in the thread, and what we see here, that the number of loops obtained in the longitudinal arrangement is half as compared to the number of loops that were there in the transverse arrangement for the same wave. If for 100 gram of weight, you are having 14 loops in this transverse arrangement, then in longitudinal arrangement, you will have 7 loops for 100 gram. So, this is the observation table. In the observation table, we have to calculate the frequency. For transverse, we have the frequency formula, that is eta is equal to 1 by 2L under root of tension upon mass per unit length of the thread. And for the longitudinal, we have the formula tension is equal to 1 by L. Here, the factor of 2 is not there. The basic difference in these formula is the factor 2. So, longitudinal has the formula T equal to 1 upon L. Eta is equal to 1 upon L under root T by M. So, what we will be calculating from the roots, we shall record the number of roots. We shall see what is the length of the thread between the P loops. Then we shall calculate what is the length of one loop, that is by dividing the total length by the number of loops. Then we shall see what load we have to M. Then we shall calculate the tension, that is mass that is added in the pan, and the mass of the pan. So that will be your T into, the T will be equal to M plus MT into G, that is 980. And then frequency you can calculate using the formula which we have discussed earlier. We can also calculate the wavelength lambda, which is equal to 2L upon capital T. And then we can verify the law, that is lambda square T law, that is lambda square by T, both for transverse as well as for frequency. Sorry, longitudinal and for transverse. So this is our experimental apparatus for the transverse arrangement. This is our battery eliminator. This is the electromagnet and this is the screw. And this here is a metal strip attached to the tuning fork. So when I touch the tip, so vibrations will be produced in the thread. As you can see here, so the loops are there in the thread. So here are the loops in the thread. We have added the mass in the pan. So we can count the number of loops, length of the thread, and do the calculation. So this arrangement is for transverse waves. Similarly, we shall do it for longitudinal waves. Now we have rotated our tuning fork to 90 degrees. So now when we give the voltage to the circuit, now when we have shifted our arrangement in the longitudinal, so for the same gate, we have now instead of 7 loops, now we are having 2 loops, 3 loops. So the number of loops in the longitudinal is exactly the half as that was produced. row from this we can calculate the number of rooms, total length of the room, weight in the pan, and using the observation table, whatever things are required, we put that quantities and we calculate the frequency of the tuning for, and also verify our lambda square T naught.